So today we're at the patient's room in Covent Garden at Cutter and Squidge, which is a bakery. They have a patient room in their basement, and you can come by and have an afternoon tea with a selection of sandwiches, and it's an experience. So you get to try out some potion making and drinking some tea and some cakes. This is the normal menu, and then additionally you can order additional, like, sort of alcoholic stuff if you like. But Julie's got the vegetarian menu, I've got the vegan menu, so there is a lot of catering for different things, which is quite
nice. You can see what the difference is. So the vegetarian is quite close to the normal one, where you can see you got pie and Yorkshire pudding, and there's like meat included in the sandwiches, and here you just have the same as a sort of vegan menu for the vegetarian. For the vegan one, they left out the pie, I think, and the Yorkshire puddings.
So it's still a good day out. But yeah, we'll show you some videos about different things that we did, and hopefully you'll like it.
Hello, ladies. Want to take your unicorns? Oh, yeah. Very majestic house, like shiny objects. Yes.
Now, stars. If I could just so briefly give it away for
fire. Oh, very good facial expressions. I like it.
All right, go on, Bex, give it a whirl.
One on the far left, that yellowy, orangey looking one there, that is venom of passion bug. Tell me, Nira, do you get any passion bugs when you live?
Nah.
Oh, really? Where do you live?
North London.
Well, there you go. Passion bugs in North London, the more South London sort of breed. They emit this fruity venom when they feel threatened to humans, and it can be toxic on our skin. We don't want to go anywhere near it. So we're going to start by picking it up. And you're going to pour it into your vial so it comes to a third of the way full. Well, you might not use all your beaker, you might not. Depends what a third of the way means.
Well, too late now.
This is what we call class walk of shame.
It may have been
right, mine. No one noticed, I don't think.
Thank you. No, no one noticed. Nice. Good.
Should have said it. We failed potions already.
Already. Yes. Snape would be real upset.
He's always real upset. Oh, yeah. Is it really sweet?
Don't get caught.
It's delicious.
Don't get caught. It's venomous.
Now, whilst one another know the tea's beginning to rise, without meaning to be patronising, it will be very hot. Alright, wait for it to cool down, wait for it to brew. Essentially, the deeper the colour of the tea, the deeper the flavour it will be. And one hand on the handle, one hand on the teapot lid, and pour like so. Please do not forget to use, because there is always one person. I'm looking at you at the back there, Becky. Don't forget to use your tea strainer when you're pouring your tea. Yes, unless you like the tea to come with bits. Anyway, back to cloths. Secondly, we'll be using this red concoction right here. This right here is dragon's blood. And I can assure you, Alice, no dragons were harmed in the making of this ingredient.
Smells like cherry.
Anyway, in goes the dragon's blood, the whole lot. Slowly and evenly. It should sit on top and not mix. Use your wand to control it now, Bex. That's a good way, Georgie. That's a good technique. Nice, Chris. Nice ratio so far. Promising.
Becky, I know you're doing the best you can.
For Becky.
Right, good. All right, look who's arrived. That's not bad, actually. I reckon
I've won. I've won the T-shirt over again.
Oh, you won't at me. Starting a jewel ship. Nice. Good. Good, Nikki. Good. Alright, fabulous. We ready to move on? Alright, great. Well, of course, now we will be using the remaining. Well, we have this last one here, students. This right here are tears. No, not here.
Doesn't smell like anything.
For the tears of eye, take a guess.
Unicorn.
Unicorn is correct! Yeah. Oh. That's awesome. The unicorn tears, the whole lot. Slowly, with great sensitivity. Now, this is tricky. Yes. It's a tricky class, but you want three colours, one on top of the other. The tears tend to want to mix with the blood.
Oh no.
Becky, that's an evil looking galaxy.
Oh no, mine did not do so well. I mean, sort of, at least I've got purple.
I'm purple.
It's half red. Yeah.
East London.
I mean, I might have been terrible at the beginning, but I think I've won myself over a little bit.
I think mine's purple.
At least I got three gradients.
Kind of. Yeah.
Oh, it was, wasn't it?
So, ideally, class, if you hold yours up to light, see how you fare. You should see blue on top of red, on top of yellow.
Purple and top of red. Yeah, you got three colors.
But now you can brew it. So lift up your wands.
We're going to brew it.
With our spells today, I'll be shouting out a word and learn the spell. You repeat it back. Sounds simple?
Yes.
All right, now this spell, what it's going to do, it's going to balance out the pH levels of that yellow and the passion bug. So don't poison our stomachs. So it is vital that you repeat everything I say. Don't say that, Nikki. All right, here we go. Passion bug. Dragon's blood. Oh no, the unicorn's crying. Alakazam.
Alakazam.
Yeah, that's enough of that. Your very first potion, give yourself a round.
Right, so Julia got methylated orange tea in her potion pot.
Smells very nice.
Smells real good. And I've got, what did I get? White tea and white tea. I like it how there's different pots. Everyone's got like, there's a cauldron down there, and there's just different pots for everyone. For your tea. It's just really nice.
Potion
is still going strong.
Very sweet.
Cauldron. She has. I'm cracking mine now. There's a gooey thing underneath. It's like a meringue. It's delicious. So this is our afternoon tea. It's really nice. Can I get it? I love this little cage. I want one for home. This is the vegan option, the vegetarian options. Little biscuits on them. The vegan plates. Very nice. Bon appetit. They're coming around with a trolley.
Is it?
Cluster and Squidge fashion. For passing our class at the potions room. And then we got a little takeaway box.
Okay.